Hello engineers, in this video I will explain how you can deploy Windows and Linux virtual machines on Azure through Terraform. Terraform is a must-have tool for DevOps engineer that enables you to deploy resources and also to perform automation actions very easily. The installation requirements for Terraform can be found on the official site in the Install Terraform section. So, except from the Terraform that you will need to have installed on your machine, Terraform is also multi-platform. So, apart from the operating system that you run, you can have Terraform installed. So, I'm currently working on a macOS, and except from Terraform, you will also need the Azure CLI that will be needed to interact with Azure, to connect with Azure, and also create a role assignment on your subscription. So I have documented the procedure on the GitHub repository that I will paste the link on the description of the video. And you will need first to have a Azure CLI installed and do an AZ login in order to log in your subscription. The Azure CLI will pop up your default browser, and then you will log in and you will be in your subscription through your terminal. Then you will have to create an RBAC role with the contributor permissions on your subscription. So you will paste your subscription ID here in those words, and you will paste it in the terminal. And a role assignment for your subscription will be created on Azure. As you can see, I have already performed this step and my role assignment has been created under my subscription, and it is the Azure CLI app that you can see here with a role contributor. So after performing these steps, you are ready to deploy your resources on Terraform. So all you need to do is to download the code that I have already provided and to run the Terraform commands. So in this repository, I have created some variables that you can use and interact with them and change them depending on your configuration. For example, you can change the password for the VM that will be deployed, the host name, the username that you want to have, etc. Also, you can change the resource group name, the location on which you want to deploy your resources, etc., etc. So I have created in this way the template in order to be extensible and also in order to be able to change the names of the variables, etc. So the main logic is behind Linux and Windows TF files, which will do the actual deployment of the environment. So depending on which machine you want to deploy, you will go and run the appropriate Terraform init and Terraform apply on the particular folder. For example, let's say that I want to deploy a Linux virtual machine. I will go in the Linux folder on this repository and I will perform a Terraform init inside this directory. Then after performing the Terraform init, I will need to Terraform apply those files, and then I will have my deployment on Azure. So let's try this in action and press the Terraform apply so that we can see what Terraform will create as a plan and what it will be deployed on Azure. So when this command runs, Terraform will let us know what resources we have instructed through the files to be created on Azure, as this tutorial is for Azure. So as you can see, we get notice about all the resources that will be created on our subscription, and we will run yes. As you can see, there are 8 resources, depending on if you run for Windows and Linux, it's the same because I create the same configuration for both machines. So it's important to know that on both Linux and Windows, we have selected the particular image that we want to have and to have deployed on Azure. So as this part is a bit tricky to find, I will provide some commands in order to know the exact name that you need to use in order to have your virtual machine on Terraform. The first command that we will use is the azvm image list that will provide us the publisher, the offer, and the SKU that we need to provide on the Terraform script. So for example, if we want a Windows server, we will select the offer Windows server, the publisher Microsoft Windows server, and the SKU, the particular operating system that we want to use. So in my example, I have selected for the Linux, the canonical, the Ubuntu version of 2004, and for Windows, I have selected the Windows Server with 2002 Data Center Azure Edition. So you can also check, for example, with this command, azvm image list offers, and select minus p canonical, you can see the names for the Ubuntu distributions. So you can also select a particular distribution and a particular offer to see more details about it, and you can do it with this command. You can change the location and also the distribution that you want to check. So after running the Terraform script, we can see that the apply is completed and the resources have been created. Also, the IP of the VM is provided and we can go on our subscription on Azure and check on resources tab for our resources. So as you can see, the Linux IP, the public IP has been created, and also the NIC that will be needed, the network security group, the main disk, and all these settings can be changed from you from the variables section that I have provided. The Linux virtual machine that is created is this particular resource, as you can see here, and is running. So we can now go and destroy this whole infrastructure that we created with Terraform Destroy. And we can also use the additional template. For example, if we go in Windows directory, we will deploy a Windows machine that is along with the variables that we have provided. So I will now go again on the Linux infrastructure and delete the Terraform infrastructure that we have created with Terraform Destroy. So when we run this command, we will see that Terraform will check the TF store to check the state of the latest Terraform apply that has been done. And after Terraform validates the state, then it will inform us whether to delete or not the resources, and we will apply yes on this prompt. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked this tutorial, please subscribe on the channel, press a like, and share this video with other engineers.